The Prime Minister in Australia is our top focus story. We'll take you straight to Sydney. Prime Minister all said for public diplomacy in Australia. There was a perfect address to the Indian diaspora at the Madison Square Garden in New York. This will be a repeat, a rerun of New York, only this promises to be bigger. That is what organizers have told headlines today on Ground Zero. Prime Minister Modi was earlier welcomed in Sydney with a traditional cultural show. He was gifted a boomerang by this group that performed for the Prime Minister at his hotel. The Prime Minister will spend 6 hours in Sydney. He'll attend a reception by the Indian community. He'll address Indians at the Alphonse Arena. The Prime Minister will try and recreate the Madison Square Garden magic in Sydney. Reports say the event at the arena has already broken all records of bookings at the venue. 23,000 people have signed up to attend this event. Major arrangements have been made both inside and outside the arena.
What is being practiced is what's called multi-layered diplomacy. One layer is in terms of international engagements at a multilateral level. Another layer is engagements of public diplomacy, where the Prime Minister yesterday and today is engaged with different sections of the public to spread a common message about his vision of India, about the India where he would like others to come and invest. Tomorrow, following this, we will then have a third element in the multi-layered diplomacy, and that is government-to-government discussions.
So as the government talks of multi-layered diplomacy, let's talk about India's soft power on display. Let me take you straight to Sydney. Headlines today is Rahul Kanwal joins us from Ground Zero with the latest. Also with me in the studio at this point of time is Javed Ansari, our National Affairs Editor, and Dilip Cherian, who's an image guru. We'll talk to all of them, but first, Rahul Kanwal on Ground Zero. Rahul, the Congress party seemed to indicate that there are crowds that are being paid to come and listen to Prime Minister Modi. You're on Ground Zero. Is this a paid crowd around you?
There's seething anger amongst the people, Gaurav, who've gathered here outside the Alphonse Arena in Sydney. They're saying, we have a message for Salman Khurshid. We want to tell him this is not a stage-managed crowd. These are people who've spent their own hard-earned money, bunked office to be here to listen to the Prime Minister. So far, we've been speaking to a whole bunch of Indians to find out what they're making of the mad jamboree outside the Alphonse Arena. I've now got two special guest reporters with Sky News, one of the popular news stations over here, Laura and Dan. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I saw you all covering this event. For our viewers, tell us, what are you making of the madness you see around you?
Well, it's good to see this many people in Homebush, and it's an amazing event. I think Modi really has captured the imagination of the diaspora of the Indian community here in Australia. And look, I've just come from the G20, and one thing I noticed about Narendra Modi is that he really does try to speak to the youth. He is very active on Twitter, and all the other world leaders were all very official in shaking hands with Prime Minister Mr. Abbott, but it was Narendra Modi who offered a big bear hug. So I think it was nice. It was very personal.
Also, tell us, as somebody who'd been covering the G20 over the past couple of days in Brisbane, what's the difference in the response that you would have seen with Modi and some of the other world leaders who came over here?
Well, I think it's hard to tell because there's so many world leaders there, but certainly Narendra Modi is seen as a big friend to Australia. We just did that historic uranium deal a couple of months ago, and that's something that had been in the works for some time. I also travelled with Julia Gillard, the previous Prime Minister, to India before Narendra Modi was in power. So, look, I think the difference between that trip and here is...
What's the difference?
It's a real festival feeling. I mean, you can't really compare India and Australia in terms of the different crowds, but there's a real festival feeling here, and I think people are really optimistic about the future of India and the trade and investment, and also his concentration on solar power and wanting to bring Indians with him. So that's what I
Tell us, how big a story is this for the Australian media?
Look, it's just massive. It's been some 28 years since an Indian Prime Minister actually visited Australia. So it is very, very significant. And I think the amount of people that we see here today really highlights that, because...
Have you seen something like this before?
Never. I've never seen anything like this before. And I think for many people here, it really represents their probably first and last chance that they may ever have to see the Indian Prime Minister. So it's just so special for so many Australian Indians.
There are lots of rock concerts that happen here, apart from sporting games. Has there ever been a political speech of this sort at the Alfonso Reyes?
There may have been.
I don't know. Yeah. Well, I think the Rolling Stones was the last big event here, and that was only a couple of weeks ago. Yeah. So.
But whether or not it attracts a crowd of this size, yeah. Well, I don't think so.
Okay. Thank you all very much for joining us. Really appreciate you taking time out from your own work and sharing your thoughts with us. Really appreciate this. Thank you very much, Dan and Laura. Thank you. Thank you. Let's just walk across and show you some of the scenes here at the Alfonso Arena. A lot of people now going in. So the crowds that were outside the Alfonso Arena now have gone in. A lot of people have come, tapped me on the back and said, Rahul, we have something to tell Salman Khurshid. We want this message to go back. This is not a stage-managed crowd. We spent hard-earned money to be here, and they're in fact very, very angry. This in some senses is like a Manish Ankar Iyer moment for the Congress once again, because he's really irked the NRI community over here. You can see the crowds. If my camera person can just point towards the gate. Now people are all making their way in. Remember, there still is about 2.5 hours to go before the Prime Minister actually starts speaking. There will be a big cultural program before that, but now people are focusing on getting in. Let's just jump across and see if we can show you some of the festivities that are taking place. You know, Gaurav, we were together at the Madison Square Garden in New York as well. And when I came in, I thought that that would probably be the pinnacle, and you can't possibly beat Madison Square Garden. But what's been interesting is to see that this, in terms of scale, grandeur, in terms of enthusiasm, is actually bigger. There's just so many more people. They probably learned lessons from what happened at New York. This is a big festival. You've got Indian community members from different regions. You've got people from the south. You've got Gujaratis. You've got Punjabis. You've got Maharashtras. All of them have been performing, and in that sense, it's been really, really remarkable. It's a far bigger carnival than the one that we saw. And okay, so this is a band called the Indoors Band. Tell us, what are you like? What are you wanting to hear the Prime Minister?
The people are playing drums from Kerala. It's a traditional drums called chenda, and the troop name is called Indoors Rhythms. Basically, it's a part of India, and they're playing in Australia, so we have grouped the two. Most of the people who are here are talented, and they have been playing this for quite a number of years, and they have been playing in different temples, and we are here to invite Modi ji and make this a grand success.
Okay, thank you. I want to just walk further back. I want to walk further back and show you the tricolor being hoisted at the back over there. And as I said, this is really a potpourri of Indian culture. People from different parts of the country. And the one thing that I've seen in previous trips with the Prime Minister is that they've always been deeply divided across communities, across religion. This is possibly the first time, Gaurav, that we've seen all these people getting back. I think everyone's now making their way in. Yes.
बहुत ही देखिए आप कितना बड़ा उत्साह है राहुल आप देख रहे हो जैसे किसी अपने की शादी हो रही हो या किसी अपने का जन्मदिन मनाया जा रहा हो ऐसा यहाँ पर एक उत्साह है तो लोग इतनी बड़ी मतलब संख्या में यहाँ
जय केसीआर जय तेलंगाना जय मोदी जय मोदी
As I said, God of one big party. What are you making of the differences between the pictures that you saw in New York and what we are seeing here in Sydney, God of?
massive crowds there, Rahul, and that is spectacular, the kind of people, and they're not just the Gujarati community, correct me if I'm wrong, there are people from Hyderabad, Telangana, Maharashtra, Kerala, people from across the country gathered there to meet Prime Minister Modi, Rahul.
Oh, absolutely. Let's in fact try and speak to some people. You got this big tricolor. How did you assemble this?
This is a really big event, and this is like a much, much bigger event than Diwali here. And Australian Indian is seeing this kind of event very, very first time.
So do you think you're being able to better Madison Square Garden?
Yeah, definitely. About it. Definitely.
How do you know? You weren't even at Madison Square Garden.
My cousin is going to perform, so I know what's going inside. So definitely it's going to beat Madison Square.
This is called the Modi Valley. This is Modi Valley. We are celebrating Diwali after 2 months. So that's why I think this is better than Diwali.
Because everyone's celebrating it with their hearts and not out of compulsion. That's why.
You celebrate Diwali out of compulsion?
Sometimes.
What does Modi mean to you as a prime minister? Do you think he's lived up to your expectations?
He's a youth icon, and India has never seen a prime minister like that. And he follows Swami Vivekananda, which most of the youth follows that. He's really doing.
Mr. President, Obama.
She wants to be on camera. She's just happy being on camera. The prime minister has landed here in Sydney, and in a short while from now. Thank you all very much. Thank you. In a short while from now, he will be coming to the Alphonse Arena. Queues now of people lining up to get in. They're all excited to listen to the Prime Minister. You have to give it to the organizers and the people who put this together, Gaurav. They really have made this one big Indian party. And every Australian I've spoken to since the morning says even the Aussie Prime Minister in Australia cannot possibly think about, let alone pull off, such a big party. Gaurav?
Stay with me, Rahul. We will continue to report on this party. But for a moment, I want to quickly cut across to Dilip Cherian and Javed Ansari. Dilip, to you first. What is Prime Minister Modi achieving through all that appears to be happening on ground zero? As Salman Khurshid said, you know, these are paid crowds that are flying to meet Prime Minister Modi. Is that what's happening on ground zero?
You know, I think that Salman's comments are clearly misguided, and I don't think we need to get beyond just making it a political issue. I don't think that's germane to the discussion. I think Sydney's crowds are clearly locals, and you can see that the enthusiasm levels are high. Modi's message is very clear. Modi is on a world tour. He's like a man who is making sure that the world understands that there's a gear shift in India. And that's his big message. So he's reaching out to governments. He's reaching out to heads of state. But he's using the local diaspora there to ensure that they get this boost that otherwise would not be possible with just political level dialogue. So multi-level dialogue that the MEA spokesperson said, yes, is an exhibition that soft power today matters a lot to global leaders, and soft power is something that leaders take on board when they're negotiating with the country.
Okay. So Javed, is this Salman Khurshid's Mani Shankar Iyer moment?
Well, this is certainly a flippant comment, and perhaps he would have been well advised not to have made this. It's one thing to oppose Modi. I'm sure that they have 101 issues in which they can join issue with Narendra Modi and the BJP government. Making such a remark is not just ill-advised, but perhaps it could boomerang, because boomerang is the buzzword right now. It could boomerang on Mr. Salman Khurshid and the Congress party, the manner in which the Chaiwala commented on Mr. Mani Shankar Iyer.